Hello friends, welcome back to Be Pharmawise. I hope you all are healthy and well. As you all know, due to COVID-19 outbreak, we all are stuck at home. The entire country is locked down and students are staying at their home. There are no physical classes going on in the colleges and your exam is about to come. So in this situation, I thought of making a series of videos for Pharmaceutical Organic Chemistry 1, which is the subject for first year BPharm semester 2. So now onwards, I will be posting a video alternate days and I'll try to cover the entire syllabus of POC 1 in this series. So if you are not yet subscribed, please consider subscribing so that you won't miss any notification, and also press that bell icon so that you will be notified as soon as I post a new video. So starting with the syllabus of POC 1, the most basic part which you must know is nomenclature. See, isomerism is one part in unit 1 which I have already covered. Structural isomerism, stereoisomerism, I have already discussed in detail. You can find the videos on my channel. But now onwards, we will focus basically on the core part of organic chemistry, and so I am starting with nomenclature of organic compounds. So why it is essential to study nomenclature, or how this system came into existence, this we first should understand. So understand ki when, go long back and understand when the scientists started to find out various organic compounds, they gave them names based on maybe their source, maybe some of the properties they are showing, or maybe for some other trivial reason. For example, when they discovered formic acid, they named it formic acid because it was produced by distillation of reed ants, and reed ants are called as formica, so it became formic acid. Interestingly, there was a woman called as Barbara, and from her name a particular class of sedatives is called as barbiturates. So this is how common names or trivial names are given, and they can be referred as nicknames, but as the organic chemistry progressed, a lot of new compounds came into existence. You know, the current number of organic compounds is exceeding 6 million. Now, you cannot give common names or trivial names to 6 million compounds. It will become very impractical to remember all the names. So, there has to be a certain system of nomenclature, right? With common names, you can identify a particular compound, but you cannot represent the structure of a compound. So there has to be a system which follows a specific set of rules. And so in 1957, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry came up with some set of rules, and which when applied, they can give you some systematic names which represent to the structural formula of the molecule. And such names, systematically derived names by applying a certain set of rules, these names are called as IUPAC names, right? So when these IUPAC names came into picture, they nowadays in current practice IUPAC names are used, but some common names were so popular and they were so widely used that they have been retained, like methane, ethane, propane, butane. These are first four members of alkane family, and these names are their common names, but they are retained. And for further compounds, the names were given according to IUPAC rules. So today I am going to discuss the IUPAC nomenclature, and we'll start from alkanes. And in the upcoming videos, we will learn all the nomenclatures for all kinds of organic compounds, okay? So before rushing to IUPAC rules, I wanted to discuss some of the basic concepts. So first, you should understand that organic compounds are made up of carbon basically. Along with carbon, there comes hydrogen. Now, there may be some functional groups present, and these functional groups may comprise of oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, chlorine means halogen, etc. So basically, we are going to discuss the nomenclature for each of these compounds, right? So first you should understand that there are different kinds of carbons in an organic compound. I will write one structure here. CH3, CH2, CH3, CH2, CH3. So look at the structure. It is a basic hydrocarbon, means it is an alkane molecule, right? So in this molecule, in this simple plain alkane molecule, there are different carbons you can see. For example, this carbon, you consider this carbon is attached to one other carbon atom, right? So this carbon is classified or called as primary carbon atom. Now coming to this carbon attached to two other carbon atoms, so it will be called a secondary carbon atom. This carbon is attached to 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms, so it will be called a quaternary carbon atom. Oh, okay. Now I will write it like this. This carbon is attached to 1, 2, 3 other carbon atoms, so it is a tertiary carbon atom. And the terminal carbons are always primary carbon atoms because they are attached to one other or no other. For example, methane, it is attached to no other carbon, but it is a primary carbon atom. So you first understand ki carbon atoms are classified in four types. First, primary carbon atoms, which are attached to one other carbon. Next, secondary, which are attached to two other carbons. Next, tertiary, which are attached to three other, and quaternary, which are attached to four other carbon atoms. So this is how the carbons are divided. Now when I am saying I'll take you through the nomenclature of alkanes, first you should learn ki how the parent alkanes are named. Now alkanes means only hydrocarbons with a single carbon hydrogen bonds, right? For example, methane, then C2H6 means CH3, it is ethane, then CH3, CH2, CH3, that means propane, so on. So as we go on increasing a carbon atom in each compound, it comprises a homologous series. Homologous series means the series which differs from each other by one CH2 unit. It is called a homologous series. So the first member of alkane family is methane, followed by ethane, then propane, then butane. Butane is for four carbons. Then for five, it is pentane. For six, hexane. Seven, heptane. Eight, octane. Nine, nonane. And ten, decane. This you need to remember. So mug it up. No other option. You have to remember this. Now when we are going in the nomenclature of alkanes, you first understand in common names, this methane, ethane, propane, butane, all these names are retained. And along with that, for example, there are two structures of for four carbon atoms, right? One is a straight chain alkane like this, and one is a branched chain alkane like this. So in common system, both of these structures are named as butane. So how you will identify the pattern or the branching? So there are some prefixes which are used in common system. So in common system for nomenclature, there are three prefixes used. First prefix is N, second is iso, and third is nu. Now when to use N, when to use iso, when to use nu, that you should learn. So N means normal or straight chain, means when the compound is only a continuous chain of carbon atoms. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is pentane, 5 carbons means pentane. So N-pentane, it is N-pentane, why all the carbons are in continuous straight chain. But when the structure is like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is again a pentane, but it is a branched chain. Now where the branching is? The branching is one methyl group at second last carbon of the chain, continuous chain. So if this is the pattern, this is called as iso. And if same, I will write the same thing. See, this is also a pentane, right? But here the branching is such that second last carbon is having two methyl groups and no other branching. Here also, second last carbon is having one methyl group and no other branching. Here second last carbon is having two methyl groups and no other branching. If this is the case, this is called as neo. So N, iso and neo were the prefixes used to identify different isomers of the alkanes in common system. N, iso, neo is not used in IUPAC systems. In IUPAC systems, we follow a completely different set of rules for nomenclating these kind of organic compounds. Okay. So for common system, I will take an example and we will write a few common names. Huh? For example, we will write a common name for this. Now what we will do, 1, 2, 3, 4, we will count the number of carbons and that will decide our parent alkane. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 carbon wala alkane means our butane. Now is it a straight chain? No. Is it iso? I think yes, because second last carbon is having one methyl group. So it becomes isobutane. This is how common names are given. I will take one more example. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Suppose I am not writing hydrogens, but you are supposed to write the hydrogens whenever you are writing the structures. For example, for each carbon, there is a valency of 4. So if this is one bond, one valency is satisfied, you have to write 3 hydrogens for this. So you will write CH3, CH3. Here you don't need to write because 4 bonds are there. CH3, CH2 and CH3 like this. Huh? You don't have the liberty of writing only the skeletons. In your exam, you have to write the appropriate number of hydrogens along with the carbon. Okay. So let's give the common name to this structure. So find out how many carbon atoms are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 carbon wala parent, hexane, right? Now, which hexane? N-hexane, isohexane, neo-hexane? It is neo-hexane. Why? Because in the straight chain, the second last carbon is having two methyl groups and it is called as neo. So it becomes neo-hexane is the common name for this kind of compound. So this is how common names are given. In common names, see, you cannot write complicated structures. For example, this structure, you cannot give a common name to this structure. Huh? You can only assign a IUPAC name for this structure. So for simple compounds, you can give common names. But for more complicated ones, you have to rely on IUPAC names. So with this discussion, I think we should now go to rules for IUPAC nomenclature. So for naming alkanes, the first rule in IUPAC system is you should select the longest continuous chain possible. Now it is not necessary that the longest continuous chain should be the one which is written horizontally, not necessary. For example, see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is the longest continuous chain. It is having no branching, nothing. We'll start with the simpler compounds, then we will go to complicated ones. So you have to write the appropriate number of hydrogens, as I told you. So this is a first compound, we will give it IUPAC name. So how many carbon atoms? 5 carbon atoms. So 5 carbon wala parent alkane, so it is a pentane molecule. Okay, now I will write one more structure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now look at this structure and tell me what is the longest continuous chain, who should be considered as parent. Now you may say 1, 2, 3, 4 and this can be considered as a substituent. But wait, now consider it like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and this can be considered as a substituent. So in this case, there are 4 carbons in a chain. In this case, there are 5 carbons in the chain. So we should always select a chain with longest, means we should always select a longest chain, means highest number of carbon atoms. So this chain will be considered as longest continuous chain and it will be your parent. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbon wala parent becomes pentane. Now, here we will not use N, iso, neo. It is in common system. In IUPAC, what we will do, this structure, this portion of compound which falls outside the longest chain, it is considered as a substituent. So this methyl group is considered as a substituent. Now, what is methyl group? I think you know alkyl groups. What are alkyl groups? Alkyl groups, when this is an alkane. If you remove one hydrogen from an alkane, you will end up with an alkyl group. So, the alkyl group is given a name based on its parent alkane. For example, this is methane. So, methane ka alkyl group will be called as ANE, will be replaced by YL. So, it will be called as methyl. So, methyl is the alkyl group for methane. Similarly, if CH3 is ethane, then one hydrogen I will remove and CH3 bond. This bond is very necessary when you are writing an alkyl group, because that indicates ki the that side is open for attachment to the longest continuous chain, right? So this is a substituent from ethane. So I will replace ANE of ethane by YL, and hence it becomes ethyl alkyl group. So here it is a methyl substituent. You are getting it? Okay. Now the next rule for IUPAC. See, the first rule we have seen ki you have to always select the longest continuous chain for carbon atoms. The second rule is, whenever there are any substituents present, you should number the longest chain in such a way that the substituent should get the lowest possible number. For example, now here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Suppose we give numbering from left hand side, then it becomes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Suppose we give from right hand side, it becomes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in any case, this carbon is getting number 3. So the substituent is placed on third carbon. So it is no any issue. But if this is the case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the structure, for example. Now select the longest continuous chain. The longest chain here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in any case, 5-membered chain is longest continuous chain. So I will select this. So for 5-membered ring, I will write it as pentane. And now if I number this from this end, this substituent will get number 4. And if I number it from right hand side, the substituent will get number 2. So what you will prefer? 2 you will prefer. So number the longest chain in such a way that the substituent should get the lowest possible number. So in this case, methyl substituent is at second position. So the name of this compound should become 2-methylpentane. Okay, so I will get back to it. First you understand ki, I think this much is understood. So whatever we have discussed ki, first rule, you should select the longest continuous chain. Second rule, you should find out any substituents are present over the chain or not. If substituents are present, third rule, you have to give the number to longest chain in such a way that the substituent should get the lowest possible number. Okay. Now what you have to do is, you have to specify the position of the substituent, just as I have done here. Now that position of a substituent is specified by a particular number, and this number is called as locant. Now what is locant? The number which specifies the position of any substituent on the longest continuous chain in alkane. So now how to write these locants, how to write the name for alkanes? We will write the name for, say, this compound. So we have seen ki 1 2 3 4 5, 5 membered, so it is a pentane molecule. First you have to identify the parent, then you need to identify the substituents, then you need to find out the locant for the substituent, and here the locant is 3, because on third carbon your methyl substituent is present. So what you will do, you will write your substituent here, methyl, and you have to give the locant. So 3-methylpentane the name becomes. Now there are certain rules. Whenever you are writing a number and again there is one letter, so they should be separated by a hyphen. And whenever you are writing two numbers, then they should be separated by a comma. So this you need to follow. And very, very, very importantly, the name of an alkane should be written as one word. There is no any space given in between. See, have I given any space between methyl and pentane? No, it has to be written as one word. So I think, I hope it is clear. Now we will take one more example and let's discuss the nomenclature. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's give a IUPAC name to this structure. First, what we will do? We will find out the longest continuous chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In any case, it is 5 member chain. So select any 5 member chain of your convenience. And most probably select the horizontal one so it becomes easier. Now you need to identify whether there are any substituents or not. So yes, there are substituents. It is one methyl group. So there are 3 methyl groups on the longest continuous chain. So for longest continuous chain, it is 5 carbon atoms. So I will write here parent, pentane. Now there are 3 substituents, and what is our next rule? We have to give the lowest number to the substituents. Now in case of multiple substituents, what you will do? See, if you give numbering from here, you will get 2, 2, and 4. If you give numbering here, 2, 4, 4. Now what set you will prefer? You have to prefer the set where the sum of locants is minimum. For example, here if I give it from left hand side, the locant set comes as 2, 2, 4, and if I give from right hand side, it comes as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It comes as 2, 4, 4. The sum of locants here is 4 plus 4, 8, and here 8 plus 2, 10. So what we have to prefer? This we have to prefer. So we will give numbering from the left hand side. So this is the set we will prefer. Okay, so now see, if there are more than one substituents and if they are same substituents, then you can use the prefixes like di, tri, tetra, etc. So di is for 2, tri is for 3, tetra is for 4, penta is for 5. Okay, so likewise, so here how many substituents? 3 substituents. Are they the same? Yes, they are same. So what we will do? We will add a prefix of tri before the name of the substituent. We don't need to write the same substituent thrice. We just need to add the prefix tri. So what we will do? Trimethyl we will write. Trimethyl pentane. See, we first identified the parent, then we identified the substituents, and we have also given the prefix tri to the substituent. Now we have to give the locants. Now we have discovered it is 2, 2 and 4. You have to write the locant for each and every substituent. You cannot only write 2, 4 trimethyl. No. Tri means you have to write 3 locants. So you will write 2, 2, 4- trimethyl pentane. See, I have separated the numbers by comma and number and letter by hyphen. So this is how you need to write the IUPAC name for an alkane when there are more than one substituent but the substituents are same. Now let me take one more example and we will go to the next rule. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 methyl ethyl 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so this example we will take. Now in this example you have to first give IUPAC name, means we first have to select the longest continuous chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In each case there are 7 carbon atoms. So I will take this as longest continuous chain. Now I have to identify if there are any substituents. So yes, there are substituents. One is methyl substituent and one is ethyl substituent. Now I have to number the longest chain in such a way that the substituent should get the lowest possible number. Now what you will do? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If you give from left hand side, or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if you go from left hand side, it is 3, 4. If you come from right hand side, it is 4, 5. So obviously you will go from left hand side. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So now at third position there is ethyl, at fourth position there is methyl, and the parent is heptane. So I will write the name. First I will write the parent, heptane. Why heptane? Because 7 carbon alkane is heptane. Then I have two substituents. Now for each substituent I have to write my locant. I have to specify its position. So which substituent I should write first? So here there is a rule ki when there are two different substituents present, you should write the substituents in order of alphabetical preference. Means here the substituent is ethyl, means it starts from E, this starts from M. E comes earlier in alphabetical order, so we have to write ethyl substituent first. Even if the number was like exchange, like here if there is ethyl and here methyl, still also you have to write 4 ethyl first in that case. Okay, so here I will write 3-ethyl-4-methylheptane. Okay, so what I have done, I have first written the parent 7 membered carbon chain, then I have identified the substituents, and then I have written the position numbers for the substituents. And what I have done, I have placed hyphen or dash between number and letter, and see number letter dash. Okay, and between two numbers there has to be a comma, like we have written here. So this is the next rule for writing the IUPAC nomenclature. Now there are certain substituents which are apart from alkyl groups. For example, now this is okay, we will take an example of chlorine for that matter. So if chlorine is used as a substituent, so here it is a longest continuous chain. So we will number the chain from right hand side so that our substituent get the lowest possible number. So it is a pentane molecule, and the substituent here is chlorine. So how you will write? So the chlorine is written, when it is used as a substituent, it is written as chloro, bromine as bromo, iodine as iodo, fluorine is fluoro. If there is OH group, it is called as hydroxy group. If it is NO2 group, it is called as nitro group. Likewise, you have to write the substituents. So here on second carbon there is chloro substituent, so I will write 2-chloropentane. No space in between. This is very important. You have to write the name of alkane as one word. If you give a space in between, mark is been cut. If you don't give dash in between number and letter, no mark. If you don't give comma in between different numbers, no mark. If you don't give if you don't write it as one word, that this is very important, no mark again. So you have to follow these rules. This is the set of rules which is need to be applied. Okay, so this is how you have to go with the IUPAC nomenclature of alkanes. Now we will take a few more examples so that the concept is absolutely clear. Chalo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Tell me, what is the longest continuous chain? 1, 2, 3? No, it is not 1, 2, 3. It is like this. This should be the longest continuous chain. It need not be horizontal always. You have to find out whether there is any alternative chain which is longer than the horizontal chain. Huh? Always find out. So again, there is substituent. So number the chain so that substituent should get the lowest possible number. So I will number it like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is basically a butane. And on second carbon, there is carbon. So methyl. So I will write 2-methyl. Butane. Okay, next 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, now the longest chain becomes this. I have drawn a 9 carbon chain, and if we have to give the locants to these three substituents, you can see from left hand side it will get 3, 4, 5, from right hand side it will be 5, 6, 7. So we have to give from left hand side. Are you understanding?
I hope yes.
So for 9 we have to write nonein. Then 3, 4, 5. Substituents are same?
Yes, they are same.
How many? 3. So we have to write tri as a prefix. So I will write trimethylnonane. And for tri, I need to give the locant. So 3, 4, 5. So how I will write 3-4- trimethylnonane. This must be the name. Okay. One more we will do. 1, 2, 3, OH, CH3. For example, now here you need to consider OH as a substituent. I am telling you, here you need to consider OH as a substituent. So in that case, what you will do? First select the longest continuous chain. Then find out the substituents. Then give the numbering in such a way that the substituent should get the lowest possible number. So we will go from this end. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the locants will be 2 and 4. If we come from right hand side, the locants will be 1, 2, 3 and 5. So obviously we have to go from left hand side. So now here what you will do? There are two substituents. You have to consider two substituents. So what you will do? If you need to consider this as hydroxy and that as methyl. So what you will write first? H or M? H. So you will write 2 hydroxy, then 4 methyl hexane. Now here I wanted to show you when OH group is placed as a substituent, how we have to write. But in general, this is an alcohol molecule because there is no other functional group attached. So this is alcohol molecule. It will be nomenclated in different way under alcohol nomenclature. But here, if you consider nomenclature of alkane, you have to consider OH as a substituent, then this nomenclature is right. Okay, so don't be confused. Okay, so I think I have covered basic rules for nomenclature of alkanes, and you should be able to give a proper IUPAC name to a structure, as well as you should decode the structure by its name. Means here we are writing the name from structure, but you should also be able to draw the structure from the name. So in that case, what you have to do? You have to go reverse. For example, I will show you how to write this structure. So forget ki I know this structure. I am only having the name. So what I must be focusing on is the last part of the name. So that is your parent. So without further thought, you just draw a hexane molecule. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is your skeleton ready. Then you know there you have to read it. Methyl hydroxy. So you immediately come to know ki there are two substituents. Now where is methyl? On 4. So first you give a numbering. You don't wait for those numbers. You give the numbering, and on that number you put the substituent. So here to second position you will put hydroxy. On fourth position you will put a methyl group. And this is your structure. It is ready. You have to draw the necessary number of hydrogens for each carbon, and your structure is ready. So I think it is sufficient for nomenclature of alkanes. I hope you have understood, and now you should practice on your own. Take any 10 structures from your book, find out any 10 structures from your textbook and try to give them the names, and then check it from the book, and practice will make you perfect. The only deal which will master, which will make you a master of organic chemistry, is nomenclature, and it is only a deal of practice. So you have to practice the nomenclature. Okay, so today we have discussed what are hydrocarbons, what are the different types of carbons present in organic compounds, primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary. Then in common system, what are the prefixes used, N, iso, neo. Then we have discussed the rules for IUPAC nomenclature, and then we have discussed the actual names for some of the alkanes. So this is all about the nomenclature of alkanes. Now in next part, we will study the nomenclature of other organic compounds. So I hope you have understood the concepts. If yes, give it a big thumbs up, and please subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends who are also stuck at home, so that they also can study for their exams. So stay tuned for the next video. Till then, bye. Stay home. stay safe.